Hello, you are watching MakeUseOf.com. My name is Ian Buckley. So today we will be using the johhny-five platform in order to control an Arduino using JavaScript. This is a fantastic library which allows people to get into robotics mostly, is what it's kind of aimed at, but as with all things Arduino, there is a huge amount you can do with it. For today, we're going to set up a servo with an Arduino Uno and use one of the example projects here in order to control it from the keyboard. So, without any further ado, let's get going. Before we set up the johhny-five library, we need to set up our Arduino. So today I'm using an Arduino Uno. You could use any other Arduino compliant board. There is a huge list of compatible boards and you can find them all linked in the main article on the MakeUseOf website. For now, this Arduino Uno will do us fine along with this small hobby servo, which you can use any, again, as long as it is Arduino compliant. So I have my servo with the red cable plugged into 5 volts, the brown cable plugged into ground, and the orange cable plugged into pin number 10. You don't have to use pin 10, but since the sketch we're using today uses pin 10 already, it makes sense, but any PWM-friendly pin will work. Once you've got the servo plumbed in, use a USB cable to attach your Arduino to the computer and open up the Arduino IDE. Here in the Arduino IDE, there really isn't much we need to do. First things first, check that under Tools you have the correct board and port selected. If you have several COM ports here and it doesn't actually tell you which board it is, you can find out that by going to your Device Manager, looking under Ports, and even if it doesn't specifically say Arduino Uno, usually you can work out what it is from there. And the sketch we need to upload to the Arduino is one of the standard sketches that comes bundled with the IDE. So look under Examples, look under Fermata, and then open Standard Fermata Plus. And once you have it, all you need to do is click Upload, and it should upload to the board. Provided that all goes well, then you are already set up as far as the Arduino goes. This is all of the actual onboard programming, as it were, we will need to do today. So let's move on to johhny-five. Before we can install johhny-five, we need to install node.js. So if you haven't already got it installed, head to nodejs.org and download whatever version you want. I'd take the recommended version if I was you. And this will give you a normal Windows installer, which you can follow through. The one thing to pay special attention to when you're installing this is that it does definitely add it to your path. This will just save you stress later on. It means anywhere in the command prompt you can run node from. In this version, it does it automatically, but it's just worth bearing in mind in case they change that in the future. So get node installed, and then we can get started installing johhny-five. Once node is installed, open up the command prompt, and we need to set a few things up just before we actually do the install. So we'll be installing it using the node package manager. If you've never used it before, you might want to run npm init just to begin with. Now, there's various things you can do with this, but I would suggest just for today, literally just pressing enter, just to get through it, because it'll initiate it once. This is something that can be changed later if you get more into Node. I'm not someone who uses it all that often, so this is all I was told to do, and it works. From here, you are now in a position where you should be able to install johhny-five. So you do that by just typing npm install johhny-five. And that will try and find all of the parts for it, and it should install all the bits and pieces. I had a couple of problems with this first time round, and that's because I didn't realize you had to initiate that. And one other thing I discovered later on when I tried to run johhny-five is that I was missing another library called keypress. So I'm going to just suggest you install that now with npm install keypress. Now, this is a much more standard library used in the Node framework in order to, as you may have guessed it, get key presses. And we'll be using that in order to get the key presses from the keyboard and use them to control our servo. So that's everything we're doing here for now. We can move back out and start doing some coding. And let's head to a text editor and start doing that. We will be using an example from the johhny-five website today. So back on the site, the code I'm using, you can find it under examples. And if you scroll down to servo, it's just this servo continuous code. Again, there is another servo here with even more different wiring to what I had before. So maybe if your wiring is like this, this will help you. And this code here is what will do the work for us today. So I've copied it into Notepad++. And before we go on, let's just have a very quick look through the code. Now, it's not important that you understand this code, but it's always worth having a look through to work it out so you know how to change it if you ever want to in the future. And this works much like any other piece of JavaScript in that you call the libraries as variables. So in this case, we have the johhny-five and keypress libraries. Keypress is a standard input process, which is what's going to allow us to interrupt the program with our keystrokes. And the board here is all part of the johhny-five library. The one thing about this, which is something I haven't really come across before, is that it automatically will find your board and port. Now, I have read that this sometimes does not happen, and there are ways you can actually specify it manually. This is all documented on the johhny-five website as part of the reference. And so, what's this program actually going to do? Well, it's going to give us the prompt of using the up and down arrows so we can move the servo clockwise and counterclockwise and press space to stop it. And if you look slightly further down in the code, you will also see that if you actually press the letter Q, it will quit the program. So now that we've been through this, save it, whatever you want to call it. I'm not particularly imaginative, so I've just called it servo.js, and I've saved it in my user folder just because that's what comes up in my command prompt, so it's easier. Now, the way that you run this is just by typing node, because we're using node to run it, and the name of your JavaScript file. And this should just work. However, I know that it is not going to, which is interesting. And I'll tell you why now. So when I tested this, the Arduino was the only thing connected to my computer. And it just found the right COM port and it worked immediately. Now I have other communication ports together and it's not able to do it, which is exactly what I mentioned earlier about it sometimes not finding the right COM port and then you have to specify it manually. So if you're having this problem, if you're not having this problem, I hope you're having a lot of fun with your servo right now. If you are, I'll show you quickly how to fix it. So back over here in whatever editor you are using, it's all here about where we specify the board, where we bring the board in by using the board function. In the brackets here, you can specify a COM port of your own. So all you need to do is add some curly brackets, some curly braces, and that's not very nicely formatted. There we go. And then just port, colon, and then the name of your COM port. If you save this and then try and do exactly the same thing again, you should find it will connect to COM port 8 automatically, and there we go, our program is working. And I don't know if you can hear that in the background, but it is moving my servo around, and hopefully there's some lovely pictures of it working as well. So this has been a very basic start with using JavaScript and Arduino together using the johhny-five library. This is by no means the only way to use JavaScript with an Arduino, but it's probably the easiest just to get started, especially if you're already familiar with JavaScript and Node and just want to fiddle around with an Arduino. Incidentally, if Python's more your thing, we have an article on the MakeUseOf website, which is exactly the same as this, just with Python as the programming language. If you just search for controlling an Arduino with Python on the MakeUseOf website, you will find that article too. I'd hope to do a lot more articles like this in the future. If there's a programming language that you would like to see working with an Arduino, please let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe for more weekly tech tips and giveaways. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.